Let's talk about Motorola Razr, the new Motorola Razr. You know, there's a new one, the foldable display. It's actually the third phone with a foldable display. No, make that the fourth phone with a foldable display that I've got my hands on. And it's quite different than the others. Yes, I'm talking about the Samsung Galaxy Fold, the Huawei Mate X, and the first one I touched, the Royal Flex Pi. My first impressions with the Motorola Razr is, yes, it checks that nostalgia box, it feels almost the same, and you want it. I don't know why, but you want it. And it's not cheap. $1,599. It's a starter price and you can only pre-order it in the upcoming months. So about the specs, they didn't insist on that part, but it has a Snapdragon 700 series, 6 GB of RAM. I don't know how much storage, but let's just say 128 GB for starters. Maybe a microSD card, because Motorola puts these kind of things in their phones. A very small battery, 2510 mAh, which is split in two. One half is in the lower side, one half is in the upper side, and two screens. The big screen has 6.2 inches and a Full HD Plus resolution. It's a POLED panel, so it's not the brightest or the most colorful OLED panel, but it looks really good. And yes, you can almost see the way it bends. The tricky part here for Motorola is that if you want to bend a small display, you have to offer support, a lot of support. So they inserted some metal thingies in the back so the display stays fit when it's open. The small display, it's not the same as the big display, and you cannot use it for everything Android related. Basically, you can read your notifications, maybe quick reply some messages, some WhatsApp messages, scroll through some notification settings. You have a widget, a dashboard that it's actually smaller than on the full size. So basically, that small screen, it's meant for you seeing the notification, maybe text a quick reply, and that's it. It doesn't make you want to open Facebook or Instagram or YouTube and spend a lot more time on your phone. That's why they insisted the small battery is enough. And I believe that. It's not made of aluminium, it's made of steel, because it has to be sturdy and resistant. And yes, it's quite splash resistant, not IP68 resistant. So you won't be able to take pictures underwater. The tricky part is, after 24 hours of playing with the phone, I still don't know how the camera performs or what size it is. Let me check that. Oh. It's a 16 megapixel camera with 4K capabilities, and that's it. You know, they haven't said anything about the camera during the event, so this tells me the phone has almost nothing special apart from the nostalgia. And yes, it is quite a pleasure to hang up on someone if you're mad at him by closing the flip phone. And no, it doesn't have wireless charging. Why? Well, it's a thing that they are thinking about for the next version. Yes, there is going to be a next version, and I'm quite sure that some people who watch this video or some other videos with the new Motorola Razr will want to get their hands on the new phone, even at that hefty price. So, this is the new Motorola Razr. It's a phone that you have to touch first before you form an opinion. I actually didn't like it when I saw the video and the specs, but after I held it in my hands for a few minutes, I quite like it. And I didn't care about the specs at all. Yes, I didn't. It's a fun thing to have in your pocket. It's so small, maybe you can put it in the spare change pocket? I don't know. So, that's it for today. My name is Radu Neagu, and see you in the next one. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and maybe share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe. Cheers.